Is it not dead and then Lord has made? I will rejoice and be glad in me. This is the day that the Lord has made. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. Oh, what a wonderful, wonderful day. Day I will never forget. After I wandered in that place away, Jesus my Savior I met. Oh, what a tender, compassionate friend. He met the needs of my heart. Shadows is failing with joy, I am telling. He made all the darkness depart. Heaven came down. Heaven came down and glory filled my soul. Yapokosikita. When on the cross, my Savior made me whole. My sins were washed away, and my night was done today. Heaven came down, and glory filled my soul. Heaven came down. Heaven came down, and glory filled my soul. When on the cross, my Savior made me whole. My sins were washed away, and my night was done today. Heaven came down, and glory filled my soul. Oh, what a wonderful, wonderful day. Here I will never forget. After I wandered in darkness away, Jesus my Savior I met. Oh, what a tender, compassionate friend. He met the needs of my heart. Shadows is filling with joy, I am telling. He made all the darkness depart. Heaven came down, and glory filled my soul. My Savior made me whole. My sins were washed away, and my night was done today. Heaven came down, and glory filled my soul. Have a message from the Lord, hallelujah. A message unto you I give. It's recorded in this word, hallelujah. It is only that you look and live, my brother, my sister, live, look to Jesus now and live. It's recorded in this word, hallelujah. It is only that you look and live. Have a message from the Lord, hallelujah. A message unto you I give. It is recorded in His word, hallelujah. It is only that you look and live. Look and live, my brother, my sister, live. Look to Jesus now and live. It is recorded in His word, hallelujah. It is only that you look and live. This is my day of joy, my day of joy, my day of joy. It is my day of joy, my day of joy. I will rejoice, hallelujah. It is my day of joy, my day of joy, my day of joy. It is my day of joy, my day of joy. I will rejoice, hallelujah. It is my day of joy, my day of joy, my day of joy. It is my day of joy, my day of joy. I will rejoice. Ever more salsa, ever more salsa, ever more salsa. Ever more salsa, ever more salsa, ever more salsa. By far, ever more salsa me. Ever more salsa you. Ever more salsa me. Ever more salsa you. Ever more salsa, ever more salsa, ever more salsa. Ever more salsa, ever more salsa, ever more salsa. Ever more salsa. Ever more salsa. Ever more salsa me. Ever more salsa you. My fire. My heaven was open. My heaven opened now by fire. Heaven was open. My heaven opened now by my heaven you was open. My heaven opened now by fire. My yabaka said it and my pussy table. Heaven open now, open now, open now, open now. Tere let me go. Yabaka shika tere bakuri babaka sadariba. Tere let me go.
Shekatini baba kasata memori baba.
That God of wonder, that God of wonder has done it again. That God of wonder, that God of wonder, that God of wonder has done it again. That God of wonder, that God of wonder, that God of wonder has done it again. That God of wonder. Lift up Jesus, He's King of Kings. Lift up Jesus, He's Lord of Lords. Lift up Jesus, He's King of Kings, and Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Lift up Jesus, He's King of Kings. Lift up Jesus, He's Lord of Lords. Lift up Jesus. He's King of Kings, and Lord of Lords. Shout hallelujah. Bashake teri baba kasandara baba. Oboko se teri baba. Send down fire. The Holy Ghost fire. Send down fire again. The Holy Ghost fire. Send down fire. Fire.
fire, oh. Fire, fire, fire.
I will call up on the Lord. I will call up on the Lord. I will call up on the Lord. You will call up on the Lord. We will call up on the Lord. Who is worthy to be praised? Who is worthy to be praised? So shall I be saved from my enemies? The Lord, amen. Blessed be the Lord. Let the rock of my salvation be exalted. The Lord, amen. Blessed be the Lord. Let the rock of my salvation be exalted.
The Lord, amen. Let me a tremble.
The Lord, amen. Let me a tremble. Amen.
Ah.
Hallelujah is an everyday. Hallelujah. Hallelujah is an everyday. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah is an everyday. Hallelujah is an everyday. Hallelujah. Come down, O Lord, and manifest your power. Come down, O Lord, come and manifest your power. In our lives today, come and manifest your power. In Jesus' name, every knee shall bow. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Power, power beyond the sky. Holy Ghost power beyond the sky. Remember me, O Lord. Remember me, O Lord. Remember me, O Lord. Today. Remember me, O Lord. Remember me, O Lord. Remember me, O Lord. Today. Today, my Lord. Remember me, O Lord. Yes. Remember me, O Lord. My apple.
Testimonies
every blocker of our breakthroughs in the name of Jesus. Rakushika Lebushi. For in Jesus' name we are prayed. Let us see that God bless you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This afternoon, we are looking at another topic that is very, very crucial to our lives and to our destinies. Very, very crucial to our lives and to our destinies. In life, you see two categories of people. The people that are succeeding and the people that are failing. The people that are blossoming and the people that are drying up. Hallelujah. Somebody is hearing the sound of my voice. I want you to shout like this. Say, powers assigned to dry up my destiny. Powers assigned to dry up my destiny. You are a liar. In the name of Jesus. Powers. I sent to dry up my destiny. I sent to dry up my wife's destiny. I sent to dry up my children's destinies. You are a liar. Die by fire. 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 Yes. Any power that is assigned to dry up my destiny. To dry up my wife's destiny. To dry up my children's destinies. I command you to die in the name of Jesus. So we are looking at the topic. War against desert spirits. Assigned to turn your life into a desert. War against desert spirits. Assigned to turn your life into a desert. Into a desert, you are a liar. Nah. In the name of Jesus, any desert spirit, any desert demon that has been assigned to turn my life, to turn my wife's life, to turn my children's lives, to turn the lives of members of this church into a desert, you are a liar. Die in the name of Jesus. 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 Any power, any spirit, any desert spirit, any desert demon that has been assigned to turn my life into a desert, you are a liar. Die by fire. Die by fire. Die by fire. Die by fire. For in Jesus' name we pray. I said there is another mystery in spiritual warfare. There is another mystery in spiritual warfare. Where desert spirits and desert demons are used in attacking the destiny of a man or a woman. Say, using desert spirits, using desert demons, shouting loud and clear. Powers, using desert spirits, using desert demons to fight my destiny, to fight my wife's destiny, to fight my children's destinies. Your hand has gone. Death by fire. Death by fire. Death by fire. Death by fire. Desert spirits, desert demons, to fight my destiny, to fight my wife's destiny, to fight my children's destinies, to fight this church. Down, down, down. For in Jesus' name we pray. In Haggai chapter 1, verse 11. Haggai chapter 1, verse 11. He said, and I call for a drought upon the land. And upon the mountains, he called upon the drought, upon the corn, and upon the new wine, and upon the oil, and upon that which the ground bringeth forth, and upon men, and upon cattle, and all the labor of the hands. I want you to rise up and pray this prayer. Say, powers! Calling the drought to fight my destiny. In the name of Jesus, powers, come in the drought to fight my destiny, to fight my wife's destiny, to fight my children's destinies, to fight this church. Die, 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 yes, die in the name of Jesus. Powers, come in the drought to fight my destiny. Come in the desert to fight my destiny. Come in the famine to fight my destiny. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. Die in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray. They can call the drought. When wicked powers want to fight a man or a woman with dryness, they call the drought. They say, drought, fight it. From this scripture, we know very well that some personalities carry the power. Some personalities carry the power and the capability to summon desert spirits, to summon desert demons, to summon drought, to summon famine, to attack a man or a woman. I said to cause both physical and spiritual famine in the life of that man or woman. Set powers! Generating physical and spiritual famine.
Generating physical and spiritual famine.
In my life. Powers! Generating physical and spiritual famine. In my life. In the name of Jesus. Powers! Generating physical and spiritual famine in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, in my parents' lives, in my siblings' lives, in this church. Die, 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 die. For in Jesus' name we pray. Some powers can make sure the life of a man or a woman is dry. Very dry. Dryness. My life. Powers! Challenging the blossoming of my life. Hear the judgment of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Powers! Challenging the blossoming of my life, of my wife's life, of my children's lives, of my parents' lives, of my siblings' lives, of this church. I sit down. 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 For in Jesus' name we pray. It's a terrible thing to fight a man or a woman with desert spirit. Look at the way desert is. That's the way the life of the person will be. Say, any power that wants my life to look like a desert.
Any power that wants my life to look like,
why don't you say it as if you mean it?
Any power that wants my life to look,
you are not my maker. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, any power that wants my life to look like a desert, that wants my wife's life to look like a desert, that wants my children's life to look like a desert, that wants this church to look like a desert, you are a liar. That by fire, 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 that by fire. For in Jesus' name we prayed. I said, number one, what are these desert spirits? What are these desert demons? A lot of people that you see today whose life is not balanced, whose life is very dry, to be honest with you, it's an evidence that they are under the attack of desert spirits, desert demons, the spirit and the demons that dry up the life of a man or a woman. So what are these desert spirits or desert demons? I said, just like you have certain types of plants and animals that can only be found in the desert areas. For example, the cactus plant. Praise the Lord. No, you cannot find the cactus plant in the rainforest. If you found one, that means somebody put it in their flower pot and they are trying to grow it. Usually it grows in the desert. Praise the Lord. I said the camels. The camels also, they live in the desert. They do very well in the desert. They are desert animals. Because they can withstand drought. They can withstand dryness. So also are those desert demons. Amen. Praise the Lord. I say these plants and animals are usually found in the desert areas. So also you find spirits and demons that are also found in desert areas. Areas with drought and famine. Praise the Lord. So what are these desert spirits and demons? I said these desert spirits and demons exhibit the character of the desert. Whenever they enter anyone, they turn that life into a desert. Amen. That is why they are called desert spirits or desert demons. Praise the Lord. Amen. The desert is usually a place of drought, a place of dryness, a place of famine. Praise the Lord. A place where anything hardly survives. Anything hardly grows. Powers! That want to turn my life into a desert! You are a liar! In the name of Jesus. Powers! That want to turn my life. That want to turn my wife's life. That want to turn my children's lives. That want to turn the lives of members of my family, the life of members of this church, into a desert. You are a liar. Die by fire. 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 For in Jesus' name we pray. So, spiritually speaking, desert spirits and desert demons are believed, amen, to carry with them drought, dryness, famine, which can easily translate to lack of dew from heaven or lack of rain of blessing. Praise the Lord. I want you to shout this prayer. Say, powers attacking my life with dryness. Powers attacking my life with drought. Can you shout the two together? Hear the judgment of the Lord. Yeah! In the name of Jesus. Powers attacking my life, attacking my wife's life, attacking my children's lives, attacking this church with dryness, with drought, with dryness, with drought. Hear the judgment of the Lord. That is attacking my life with drought. That is attacking my life with dryness. That is attacking my life with famine. Die by fire. 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 For in Jesus' name we pray. Meaning that this desert spirits block a man or a woman from receiving dew from heaven. Or also stop them from receiving showers of blessings. Say, powers! Blocking me from receiving the dew of heaven. Powers! Blocking me from receiving the dew of heaven.
In the name of Jesus, some of us die, 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 some of us die. Any power that is blocking me, blocking my wife, blocking my children, blocking my family, blocking this church from receiving the dew of heaven, from receiving the showers of blessings, die, some of us die.
I said a lot of souls would have been turned, amen, a lot of souls would have been turned into a desert life if not for the divine intervention of the living God. What those desert spirits want is for everybody to become like a desert. Isaiah 58 verse 11. Isaiah 58, 11 say, and the Lord shall guide thee continually and satisfy thy soul in drought. The Lord shall guide thee continually and shall satisfy thy soul in drought. Raise up your two hands and shout.
Say, by the power in the blood of Jesus, my soul shall be satisfied in drought. In the name of Jesus. By the power in the blood of Jesus, my soul, my wife's soul, my children's souls shall be satisfied in drought. In the name of Jesus, our souls shall be satisfied in famine. In the name of Jesus, our soul shall be satisfied in dryness. In the name of Jesus.
What that scripture is saying, that no matter what happens, your soul will be satisfied. Let us see that. And make fat thy bones. Praise the Lord. Thou shalt be like a watered garden, and like a spring of water, whose water fail not. Praise the Lord. Raise up your two hands again.
Say, I shall be like a watered garden. Whose water does not fail. In the name of Jesus, I shall be like a water garden whose water does not fail. In the name of Jesus, I, my wife, and my children shall be like water gardens whose water does not fail. In the name of Jesus.
For in Jesus' name we pray. Don't worry. You are going to blossom very soon.
Amen.
Oh, yes. Everybody that is looking at you now, you are looking very dry. Very soon, you will begin to blossom. You begin to flourish like a palm tree. In the name of Jesus. One of the worst things that can happen to any man or woman is to cut off the spiritual spring of water from the garden of their lives. Praise the Lord. I say it is like stopping the sprinklers from wetting the grass during the peak of the summer heat. Say, powers that want to cut off my life.
That
want to cut off the garden of my life.
From
the spring of living waters.
Powers that want to cut off
the garden of my life. The garden of my wife's life. The garden of my children's lives. From the spring of living waters, hear the judgment of the Lord. Fall down, fall down, fall down, fall down, fall down, fall down. For in Jesus' name we pray. I say, of course, the grasses will suffer drought and they will all dry up. This is the same thing that happens when some powers and personalities decide to fight you with desert spirits or desert demons. It's like summer coming very hard and all the grasses are drying up. That's the way they fight some people's lives, with desert spirits, with desert demons. They dry up the life. I say everything in the life of that man or woman, amen, will eventually dry up when, if any power or personality decides to fight them with the desert spirits or desert demons. So number two, what happens when a man or woman is under the attack of desert spirits and demons? Or what happens when a wicked personality decides to fight a man or a woman with desert spirits and demons? I want you to pray like this. Any satanic personality in my father's house, in my mother's house, in my in-law's house, in my place of birth, in this land of America, that is fighting me with desert spirits, be destroyed by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Amen. So what happens? Praise the Lord. When they are attacking you with desert spirits. If you look at Jeremiah chapter 50 verse 12. Jeremiah 50. Let us see that. God bless you. He said your mother shall be so confounded. She that bear you shall be ashamed. Behold, the innermost of the nation shall be a wilderness, a dry land, and a desert. You know, sometimes, please sit down, man. Somebody looks at their son and their daughter and they begin to cry. That what is happening to you? You can't get a job. You can. I met a boy that was talking to me. Praise the Lord. And was telling me everything that was going on in his life. You can see that desert spirit is already attacking their life. Because when the desert spirit is attacking the life of anyone, they finish and destroy everything that is there. The Bible is saying here that even the mother that gave birth to the man or woman shall be so confounded, so troubled, so disturbed when they see the havoc that desert spirits do, amen, to their children. The Bible says, he that bear you shall be ashamed, meaning that when the mother that bore the man or woman that is under this desert spirit attack see them, they will be greatly ashamed, they will be greatly distressed. Praise the Lord. Because the flourishing life would have turned into a wilderness. The flourishing life would have turned into a wilderness. And what is a wilderness? Wilderness means no road. No headway in life. Confusion and failure. That's part of the symptoms of being under the attack of desert spirits. Confusion. No headway. Even in the physical desert, a real desert, if you enter a real desert, at some point you don't know where you're coming from. You don't know where you're going. That's why a lot of people get confused in the desert and they get lost. A dry land, meaning that every department, every area of the life of the man or woman that is under the attack of desert spirit shall become very dry and unproductive. Become very dry. Become unproductive. There will be spiritual drought and famine in every area of their lives. A complete desert life. And it's very, very funny. There are millions and millions of people going about with desert life. They have cut off the garden of such lives, even from the spring of living water. Unfortunately, we are preaching to them to give their lives to Christ so that they can be reconnected. But they are looking at you as the joker. Praise the Lord. I said, just the same way wicked personalities use the spirit of the grave or graveyard spirits, graveyard demons, to fight a life and a destiny, or the life and the destiny of a man or woman. They also use the desert spirit and desert demons to dry up a man or a woman's life and destiny. You know, when they are fighting a man or a woman with what you call graveyard demons, graveyard spirits, the essence of that, amen, is to kill anything and everything in their lives. They kill marriage, they kill career, they kill job, they kill business, they kill friendship, they kill relationship, they kill anything that is killable. And the essence is to eventually kill the man or kill the woman. For the desert spirit, they don't kill the person. Or you can say, they kill the person while the person is still alive. Amen. I said, the moment you begin to experience drought or dryness in your life, in your relationship, in your marriage, in your job, in your career, in your investment or business, in your well-being, in your wealth, in your health, you may be under the attack of desert spirits and desert demons. Dryness. When some powers want to be really wicked, when they want to be very, very wicked, they don't want to kill you. No, they don't want to kill their victim. They want them to suffer while they are still alive. They just want to dry up their lives. They introduce desert spirits and demons into the life, that will stop the dew of heaven and the showers of blessings from coming upon the life of their victims. They don't want to kill the person. They just say, let nothing work in their lives. Amen. Let everything be shut down. Say, powers assigned to shut down my destiny, be buried alive in the name of Jesus. Powers assigned to shut down my destiny, assigned to shut down my wife's destiny, assigned to shut down my children's destinies, be buried alive, 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 yes, be buried alive in the name of Jesus. Any power that has been assigned, that has been programmed to shut down my destiny, to shut down my wife's destiny, to shut down my children's destinies, be buried alive in the name of Jesus. Any power that has been assigned to shut down MFM Tampa, Florida, be buried alive in the name of Jesus. Be buried alive in the name of Jesus. Be buried alive in the name of Jesus. Amen. In Psalm 104, verse 13 to 15, the Bible says, he watereth the hills from his chambers. Which means God naturally waters the hills from his chambers. The earth is satisfied with the fruit of thy works. When the water is pouring on the hills, on the lands, the plants begin to grow, the fruit begin to come out. The Bible says, he causes the grass to grow for the cattle. He provides food for everyone. And the herb for the service of a man, that he may bring forth food out of the earth. And wine that maketh glad the heart of man. And oil to make his face to shine. And bread which strengthens man's heart. Look at it. He gave him oil to make his face shine. Bread to strengthen his heart. Praise the Lord. Wine to make him glad. Praise the Lord. Food to make him strong by bringing, amen, what? Water from, to water the hills from his chambers. I said, these are the products of prosperity that a man or a woman enjoys when their lives, amen, are not under the attack of desert spirits and desert demons. You are supposed to have wine. You are supposed to have food. You are supposed, you know, to be glad, oil to shine your face. It's a symbol of prosperity. But the moment desert spirits and demons enter into the spiritual curtain of a man or a woman's life, everything ceases. Rise up and shout this prayer. Every desert demon, shout it louder than that. Every desert demon in the garden of my life, in the name of Jesus. Every desert demon in the garden of my life, in the garden of my wife's life, in the garden of my children's lives. I command it to die. 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 In the name of Jesus, every desert demon, every desert spirit, in the garden of my life, in the garden of my wife's life, in the garden of my children's lives, in the garden of my parents' lives, in the garden of my siblings' lives, in the garden of members of this church, die. Jesus' name we pray. And I said, instead of them to be experiencing the kind of prosperity that heaven has just talked about, food, oil, wine, bread, everything is supposed to come, you know, supernaturally, without any problem. But when the desert spirit enters, everything ceases. Amen. I say, instead of them to be, instead of the man or the woman, amen, that is under the attack of desert spirits, will now begin to enjoy the prosperity that heaven has naturally and supernaturally made available to them, amen, they'll be experiencing poverty. I say, the trademark of their lives will only be drought, famine, hunger, failure. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. There are a lot of people under the attacks of these desert spirits and desert demons. And they are experiencing terrible dryness in every area of their lives. But they don't have a clue where the sources of their dryness is coming from. Some people suffer dryness from the very beginning of their lives to the very end of their lives. It is when you know what your problem is that you know the kind of solution to profess to it, isn't it? They don't have a clue. If some of them believe, they say, well, I'm well known. It is natural. Maybe that's how God wants it to be. Not knowing that some spirits and some powers are fighting them with desert spirit. I said that power is really enjoying using desert spirits and demons to attack their victims. Because it affords them the ability to see their victims suffer very terrible dryness while they are still alive. So they want to watch you dry. They want to watch you suffer. They want to watch you struggle. That's why they introduce that spirit. That spirit will naturally not kill you, but will kill every good thing in your life. Pray this prayer again. Say, powers, killing good things in my life. Powers, killing good things in my life. Expire. Die. In the name of Jesus. Powers, killing good things in my life, in my wife's life, in my children's lives, in this church. Expire. Die. Expire. Die. Expire. Die. Expire. Die. For in Jesus' name, they are dead. I say, of course, a lot of people have committed suicide when they could no longer cope with the terrible impact of spiritual dryness in their lives. Some killed themselves because they didn't know the way out. They tried everything. They didn't know it was a spiritual problem. They tried everything physical. Some will say, oh, maybe I don't have the appropriate degree. They go to school. They even spend 4-8 years. They come out. All because they are dealing with the spirit of the desert. Even the certificate will just be ordinary paper. Praise the Lord. Amen. So, peradventure, you are hearing the sound of my voice this afternoon. And you are going through some unexplainable chronic dryness in your life. What can you do to reverse it? What can you do to overcome it? Praise the Lord. And if you look at the life of a lot of people, even if not in every department of their lives, you can see in some departments that they are very dry. That department has been turned into a desert by desert spirits. I said, this is a very serious and strong spiritual warfare. In fact, because desert spirits and demons are very stubborn, they do not give up easily. Can you compare a donkey, or let's say a horse and a camel? While a camel is still going, donkey is already, a horse is already dead. Because they have the resilient power to withstand heat, especially. And you are thrown fire at them. They are in the desert, they are used to heat. They are used to fire. That's why a man or a woman that is going through dryness really need to pray. It's not a bad prayer, you pray for a short time and you run away. It's like a lifetime prayer. Because the more you try to bombard them with prayer, the more they try to search back at you. I say, just like the physical plants and animals, amen, are very resilient in the desert. Look at the cactus plant. It's supposed to be like a leaf, but it is like a stem. It's very hard. Not only that, they now put spikes on the stem so that even when you want to touch it, it spikes. So also are desert spirits and demons. They do not leave their victims very easily. That's why you see some people, dryness continued in their lives for years. Some people, the dryness buried them. Especially when they don't know what the problem is and they don't know the kind of solution to offer to it. That's why you need, praise the Lord, to give your life to Christ. When you are going through dryness in your life, you need Jesus to fight the battles for you. Because desert demons, desert spirits, they don't listen to any voice except the voice of Jesus. Look at that man in Mark chapter 5. That everybody was saying was a madman, that he located to the tomb. The Bible says people tried to help him. But those demons don't listen to any voice. They only hear and listen to the voice of Jesus. And if you look at that Mark chapter 1 from verse, chapter 5 from verse 1 to 5, the Bible says, until Jesus came into the city, the man was not delivered. But the moment they saw Jesus from afar off, the Bible says, they bowed down to worship him and ran to Jesus. And even started challenging Jesus, why have you come? It is not our time. Why do you want to come and send us out now? Jesus said, shut up, what's happening? He said, we are in danger, for we are men. And started begging Jesus, please, because we have not finished our assignment in this environment, we still have to destroy a lot of people. Please don't send us out of this territory. Just send us into those pigs. They themselves asked Jesus to send them into where they wanted. Desert spirits. Very stubborn. Very, very resilient. I say, because Jesus is the only one they dread and they fear. It's only Jesus they fear. Because they know that he is the Son of the living God. Amen. So all you need, give your life to Christ. But not like everybody, I'll give my life to Christ and Christ is not in their lives. Christ has to enter into your life so that he that is in you can be greater than them. Confess all your sins. And repent, because they also hide behind sins to attack a man or a woman. The Bible says, he that hide his sin will not prosper. If you are committing little sin, all these demons are looking at you. They can come and attack your business, attack your job, attack your investments, attack your career, attack your marriage, attack. In fact, they will attack anything that is attackable in your life. They are very ferocious demons. And all they will introduce into their life is poverty, lack, struggling, suffering, amen, drought, famine, amen, hunger. I say, break every known and unknown evil covenant that they use, amen, to attack you. Because if there are covenants in your life and you are not also aware of, they'll be using it to attack you. Live a holy and a righteous life. That is the most basic. That one will help you a lot. Your holiness can also destroy evil causes and covenants in your life. If you really live a holy life. Because the Bible says, who shall lay a charge of a thing against the elect? Is God that justifies. And Galatians 3:13-14 says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made curse for us, for it is written, cursed is every man that hangeth on the tree, so that the blessings of Abraham can come unto the Gentiles through Christ Jesus, and so that we can receive the promise of the Spirit even through faith. Your holiness can actually help you. Holiness in Christ Jesus, righteousness in Christ Jesus, but you need to take it to a very high level. Where heaven will say, yes, he's a holy man. Job chapter 2, God told Satan, he said, Job is a faithful man, he's a man of integrity, he's a man that eschews evil. Praise the Lord. I say, spend more time with God and with the people of God. Spend more time. All this prayer meeting that we are organizing now, a lot of people don't understand that your destiny needs these prayers more than anything. While you are busy running all over, up and down, trying to get bread, oil, wine, for yourself, the desert spirit is busy attacking. That's what you are trying to get. That's why you see some people, the Bible says they make money, but they put it in bags with holes. He said they eat and they are not satisfied. They drink and they are still thirsty. Why? Because the desert spirit is fighting them. Be very prayerful and read your Bible all the time. Praise the Lord. I say reading your Bible all the time and worshiping God all the time will create the presence of God around you and will not, amen, and these demons will not be able to come near you. Now why we are telling you, read your Bible, worship God, pray, you don't understand. Because the Bible is the word of God, and the word of God is God. Anytime you are dwelling on the word of God, you are actually building the presence of God around you. The more the word of God you read, you meditate upon, you confess, the more of God that will be in the atmosphere around you. And if God arises, what will happen to his enemies? Let us rise up. Praise the Lord. You are here today and they are fighting you with desert spirit. I pray for you. Whosoever it may be, whether it's your blood relative or it's an outsider, anybody fighting you with a desert spirit, the same spirit will turn back to fight them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. And every good thing, the wine, the oil, the bread, amen, that they have killed and they have destroyed in your life, the Lord will give you new wine and new cup. In the mighty name of Jesus. As a prophet of the living God, I prophesy to your life again that let your life begin to prosper from today. Let your life begin to prosper from today. Let your life begin to prosper from today. In the name of Jesus. They turned your life into a desert before you came here. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I convert your desert land into a rainforest. In the name of Jesus. I convert your desert land into a beautiful garden, an orchard, in the name of Jesus. You will no longer experience dryness. In the name of Jesus. From today, you will flourish like a palm tree. You will flourish like a tree that is planted by the rivers of water. In the mighty name of Jesus. It shall be well with you. It shall be well with every member of your household. Because of your destiny, because of those that are connected to your destiny, heaven will lift up your head in the name of Jesus. Today, every good door that has been locked against you, that has been locked against me, shall open by fire in the name of Jesus. I say Ephrata in the name of Jesus. I say Ephrata in the name of Jesus. I say Ephata in the name of Jesus. From today, every good door will not be open to us.
Amen.
By the power and the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
And today is our day of greatness.
Amen.
The Lord will establish us by mighty power.
Amen.
He will promote us by fire.
Amen.
We shall advance by fire.
Amen.
Impossibility shall be made possible in our lives today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That business you want to do, the Lord will support you.
Amen.
Everything you need to do the business, heaven will supply you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your dryness, your drought, your famine, your hunger expires and dies today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And your prosperity starts now.
Amen.
Your abundance starts now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your showers of blessings has just started.
Amen.
Father, we bless your holy name. Thank you because this your children will continue to live a holy and a righteous life. So that the devil will not destroy the good garden that you have given to them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We also pray for this church, Lord. Continue to enlarge the coast of this church.
Amen.
By the power of your holy name.
Amen.
Take all the glory. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Let's take our tithe and offering very quickly. God bless you in the name of Jesus. It's always very good to bring something, no matter how small, and put it in the offering basket as a point of contact. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Let us rise up. Everlasting Father, Lord, we bless you. We thank you because this is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. It is our day of divine establishment. It is our day of divine promotion, divine elevation, and divine transformation. From today, no one on this mountain will ever experience dryness again in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any power, any spirit, any personality that dares to fight anyone here with desert spirits and desert demons, they shall be destroyed with their spirits and with their demons in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, because we bear the mark of Christ, no man, no devil will trouble us in the name of Jesus. Shall be well with us.
Amen.
Shall be well with our spouses.
Amen.
Shall be well with our children.
Amen.
Shall be well with our children's children.
Amen.
Shall be well with this church.
Amen.
Father, accept this tithe and offering in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Enlarge our coast by your power. In the name of Jesus. Bless us with blessings that room cannot contain.
Amen.
Do in our lives today what no man can do. In the name of Jesus. Even as we go, Father, go with us. Devour the devourers for our sake. Enlarge our coast. In the name of Jesus. Let there be uncommon breakthroughs. Uncommon testimonies. Thank you, Father, for everything. For in Jesus' name we are prayed. The rest of the week shall be glorious. In the name of Jesus. No evil shall befall anyone here. The only news you will hear this week is supernatural good news. In the name of Jesus. I will hear good news from you. You will hear goodness from me and my family. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' name we are prayed. Let us share the grace now. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Seven powerful hallelujah, let's go. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. God bless you. Thank you for coming.